Hello and welcome. Now and next I am planning to show you that how to open this cylinder head cover. And first what I need to do is to open these four bolts in here, what are in there, and I have already take those three out and there is one left, and for that I need a socket, what size is 3/8 inches, and I install this socket in that bolt and I open that bolt. Okay. And next step is to take this this plastic cover out, and we continue. Okay, and then when we are doing this job, it's important that we take this battery minus cable away, and for that we need friends, what the size is 13 millimeter. And that friends fits in here, and we take battery cable away that in this way, and then we can continue. Okay, and next step is to take this plastic cover out. And then when we are taking this cylinder head cover out, we need to take these ignition coils in here out, and also spark plugs out, and we start to take those out, and here is a bolt, what size is again 3/8, and same as 10 millimeter. And I install this socket in here. And now there was that kind of bolt. And then there is this small clipper, and I press that in here, in this, and then this this wire goes away, and then I can lift this ignition coil. Okay, and then I need to do that same thing all of those ignition coils, and when I have take those out, we continue. Okay, and now I have take all of these ignition coils away, and then next step is that there are a couple of pipes and hose, one in here and then also one in here. We need to take also these pipes away, and there is idea, and there is this small pin that you press in your fingers, and then this pipe opens, and here is same idea, you press your fingers and then pipe away, and then you install this pipe carefully a little bit away, and please sure that those metal pins don't don't go lost. And then next step is that we need to take also this spark plugs wires out, and there is one and two bolts. What is in Toyota weight is 3 divided 8 socket again, and this fits in here, and I open also those two bolts. And then I use that kind of wrench tool. Okay, and it is open. And then I have also smaller bar where I can use my hands. This is also very easy to do. And okay, and there was that kind of bolt, and then I take that bolt also away, and when I have take that away, we continue. Okay, and now I have take those two bolts away in there, and we can move this wire cable in there. Okay, and next step is then that we need to open these bolts in here, what are in here is first one, then second, and here is third, and then fourth, and just in behind of in here is fifth in here, and here is 6th and 7th and 8th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, 8 bolts. We need to open 8 bolts. And let's look also those little bit. What is in here, and here are also those couple of bolts are in there, and they are very easy to take out. And again, in here we have in this Toyota way, we have again the same socket, what size is 3 divided 8, and this fits in here also. And let's go to take those bolts out. Okay, and I start in this bolt, what is in here. There is this bolt, what is just in there, and I start in this bolt, and this fits in there, and then a little bit move, and this bolt opens easily. These Toyota bolts opens normally very easily. They are so high quality material and workmanship. And here there was that kind of bolt. And then I continue. I go to that bolt. And I open also that. Okay, and I continue to also those other 8 bolts. And when I am ready, we continue. And we look at what we do next. Okay, and now there is only one bolt left, and I open that bolt in here, and it is in here. Okay, and now we have opened all of those bolts, and next we need to take this cover out, in this cover. And how this happened? It happens so that you need some wooden lock, and because we need to, sometimes this opens so that I move a little bit, but now this cover is stuck and it don't move, and we need wooden lock, what we use like hammer. And here I have one wooden lock, what I use a little bit hammer this aluminium block, and let's look what happened. And then, by the way, and then when we have take all of these 8 bolts out, there is 2 bolts left in there in this central area. And there is this first, and there is this second. And there is the same socket, 3/8, fits also in these bolts, and we open also those bolts. And this was very easily, not very, this was not, they were very loosened, there was not much moment, and when we install these bolts back, we need to use this moment tool, because otherwise we can destroy these bolts and also this cylinder head cover. And what kind of bolt is here? Interesting to see. Is this very okay? And it's very. It's now open. And there is idea that these bolts, they. I think that they don't go out. And please leave those bolts in. Okay, and please leave these bolts in here. Don't pull those out. This is fine. And then next step is that we need to start to move this cylinder head first in our hands in this way. And when this cylinder head is stuck, it's stuck in here, we need to hammer a little bit this cylinder head using that kind of wooden lock. Then we hope that this cover opens, and okay, and I continue this hammering, and we continue soon. Okay, and then when this cylinder head cover is normally stuck and very thick then, and there is glue in there between this cylinder head cover and then this cylinder head, we need to do then next trick and hint that we can take this cylinder head cover away, because now there is important thing that there is this cylinder head gasket in just inside of this cylinder head cover, and we need to protect that gasket, and we have to be really carefully that we don't destroy that gasket when we open this cover. And then we need a special tool, like a small screwdriver, where is that kind of head, what is very sharp, and idea is that you could insert. Okay, and there is also possibility that if you have some old knife, like that kind of knife, where is not very sharp this knife, you insert then this knife in just in here, and then we take a little bit closer picture that in what area you insert that knife, just in this is cylinder head cover and this is cylinder head, and just in here, and you insert that in that way, that in, because in just in here is this gasket, and we can little bit open this cover so far away that we might hit pretty very carefully this bolt. And this, then you need hammer, that you can hammer this knife, and I insert the knife in there, and then a little bit hammer, and as you can see, this cover opens, and then we need to do same thing in this other side, what is just in there, but there this situation is different. I can't insert this knife in there because there are wires and this fuel pipe, and I need to use this small screwdriver, what I insert now in here, in that way I insert it is just in there, and I try to be so carefully that I don't destroy this gasket inside in there, and I insert that tool in there, and then a little bit hammer again. I take my hammer and a little bit hammer that second try, and there, what is the place? It's of course interesting to see. I insert that in just in there. There is this place where I insert this hammer, and okay, and I insert that in there, and then I okay, and it opens nicely. This cover moves now. Okay, and then we need to do that opening also this back area, and this back area, it is, I mean this back area, it is just in here, and let's go to look also that area, what is in there. Okay, and then we look this back area also, and there is that point, what is in here, and for that area I use in there my hammer, but now this hammer other side, there are those two hooks, and I insert that hammer in there, and then I carefully I insert that in there, And then I change this, I rotate this hammer a little bit, and now this cover is open. Okay, and now I think that our cylinder head is released, and next we can lift out this cylinder head. Okay, and next we think that the cylinder head is released and it is not anymore thick then. And then I take my both hands in here and I lift this cover a little bit, move that, and now there is this gasket what I said, and I take this, and there is take this gasket out in this way, and there is now idea that I will reuse this gasket if it is okay, and I use my hand that okay. There is this, and I use this gasket away, and then remember that now this gasket is in right place, and it's good to remember that this area is up. And also I noticed that there is some silicone glue in this area. We need to remember, because when you take this little bit out, you can notice where is this glue we need to use, and we continue. Okay, hello and welcome. Now I want to tell a little bit this Toyota's VVT-i engines and this working method, that how it working, and just inside of this metallic part there is this VVT-i systems core machine, and it works inside in this machine, and this is this VTT systems this hood, and this what controls this valve automatic, and there is this chain what is very ticked when I press that, and this chain last very long time. I have heard that this chain can last something like 400,000 miles or even more, and then when we need to change this chain, normally this chain start to give sound, that is it rattles and generate sounds like in a bicycle chain, but now this is very thick, and then we can also look this camshaft. There is two camshaft in there. This is like intake and this is outtake, and there is exhaust pipe, and here are those fuel injectors, in this centrum area there are those spark plugs what are in these holes in four, and there is this gasket, and when you notice that you have some oil inside of those spark plugs, then this gasket is leaking just in here, and you need to only install in there this gasket glue, And then there is this cylinder head gower gasket, what we normally could reuse when we clean this gasket and we install only glue in just in below of this gasket and this cylinder head just in here. Okay, and interesting. This is this Toyota's VVTi system, and it is just inside here. And if you are interesting, it's also possible to deassemble because there are those bolts inside of that. Okay, and here is this cylinder head cover. And when we think that where this leak was, when we are thinking that where this leak was, and it was in that hole, and then we go to check that what is this hole's situation and how much there is this oil. And let's look. And there, yes, this is full of oil, but there is no oil, and also there is no oil, and there is no oil. Okay, and it is the first cylinder. Okay. And we need to install in there now this glue. In that area in here when we take this, there is this gasket and we need to install a glue in just inside of that. Okay, we continue. Okay, and then next step is that we need to have a clean cotton cloth material, and we need to clean all of these gaskets areas in here, and also in here we need to take those oils away in these parts, and there is this in this way that this is clean and there is this oil, and I need to take this oil away in there and also in there. And also I need to clean this gasket. I take that in my hand. In here. It is in hand, and then I need to clean all of these oils in away in here. Because next we need this glue that we insert in there, and glue this is special glue, and let's go to look this glue, that what kind of glue I have. And then be carefully when you are in that kind of area where is this oily sand in, like in here, that you don't drop this oily sand in inside of this area. Clean these things in there and change this your cotton cloth enough often that there is this, not this cleaning, not this dirty goes inside of this motor area. And we continue. Okay, and then you need that kind of Loctite or some other good brand this high temperature foam a gasket glue, and when I open it there is this glue what looks like that, and that I am planning to insert in there, and there is information in this back area that there is saying that this glue can last last this entire, that this can last 315 Celsius, this heat, and it's like Loctite 1372 or something else. And there's also information that it can there is this very good pressure skills and abilities in this glue. And but before of that, I need to clean all of this gasket and the side in there. And here is this side, what I mean, where this gasket goes, and it is in here, and I need to clean all of this very carefully. And then be careful that when here is this sand, that you don't drop this sand inside in there, because this sand is very harmful to our motor. And next I will clean all of these parts, metallic parts, and also this gasket using cotton cloth and new cloth, and after that we will install this glue in those areas. Okay, and we continue. Okay, and then I have take this whole gasket away, and now I clean surfaces that there is not much oil. I try to take all of those oils away. And also in here, those central parts, and because I don't, and of course you could purchase new gasket, and then it works better. But I think that we could use that. And now I think that this is clean, and then I need to insert this Loctite gasket glue, and I start this glue in this central areas, those spark plug holes, and I insert that in not too much, and let's look. There is this, and then and just in every part, and then you, if there is extra, you can take this out in this cotton cloth, okay, the next one, and then be carefully that you don't insert this glue in too much, because then this glue goes in this motor area, only in this metallic plates, and then in there. Okay, then this last part. Okay, and now I have insert this glue in there, and then I need to insert this glue in here. I start in here, and actually it is good to use a little bit finger. Okay, and I then little bit smoothly in all of these metallic plates, and next I will do this whole part and then we continue. Okay, and now I have installed this glue in all areas in there, and I have to say that this glue is not maybe the best solution, because this glue looks quite interesting, but I will test that now. And but in to you, I recommend that you purchase new gasket and insert new gasket in this cylinder head. But let's look at how this works, and next step is that I need to install this gasket back. And there was thing that in some point there was this old glue, and it's easy to remember that this goes in that way firstly, and this lower area in here is this most critical, and then I insert this old gasket in this places this way, okay, and especially this area is important because it is lower. Then I press this gasket in there. Okay. Interesting to see that how this works. And then this central part, I press this in there. I don't like those leaks. Okay. Soft press and this way. Maybe I had a little bit too much glue, but let's see. And then when this is finished, I take this cylinder head cover and I insert that in back. Okay, and here is the cylinder head cover, and I take that oil knob in there, and then I insert that in carefully. There is this support bolts, and first in there, just in there, and then carefully in same side. There was something wire a little bit, so let's look at how it went. And then it's important to check all parts that this this gasket is in okay. Then when you think that Everything is fine. Well, I think that there is some parts in here I need to reassemble. Okay. Okay, and then I think that I reject this again. That is still everything fine. I'll reject that. Is this gasket in okay? And this gasket looks to be okay, and then we can start to tighten this bolt, and I will also show to you how this gasket is there. There is this gasket, and also in there, and just in there. I think that I have now a little bit, maybe too much, this gasket glue, but I think that this glue might become solid and it will be in there. And I think that this glue has been work quite nicely. Okay, and then I insert this cover back again, and we have next step to thicken those bolts. But I have to say that in now I recommend to everybody else that it is better to purchase new gasket and insert that in there, and please insert this new gasket in these holes, and then you only drop that in there, because now when I insert this old gasket in there and glue in there, it is not the best way. And but in next time I will purchase new gasket, and I insert that gasket in this hole, and then it's really easy to drop like in this way. But let's see that how this works. If there is any oil leaks, then I have to take this cover open again and change the new gasket. Okay. Okay, now it's in there. It's in back in there. And yeah, I think that it's okay, and then I start tightening. But I tighten these bolts in here. First, those two, we start in there, and here was this special moment, but I think that it is not much, it's very, I tighten both of those, and this I check this moment, and we continue. Okay, and then I have here this my moment two, and here is my moment tool, and I am planning to use this 10 LPF foot, this moment. It is not very much in there. There is 20 and 0 and 20, and I use only 10. And I start in here, and all bolts goes to this 10 LPF foot. And I first tighten these first bolts, and I do so that a couple of turns, that right one and then left one. Okay, and then continue. And when I thicken this bolt, I check all time this measurement, that when it goes, it moves in here, and it's something like 5 now, a little bit more. This is very basic moment tool. This is not very expensive cost. And now when you look this arrow, it tells that it is almost 10. And now I am happy that these bolts are okay. Also that one. Okay, it's also 10. And then next step is to install back all of these smaller bolts. What I mean, that size, and they goes in here this way. And there is that one, and it goes in here. Goes in here, and then this one, it is some special place. Now check again, this longer goes in here. Okay, and when I have inserted those bolts, we continue. Okay, and these smaller nuts goes in these corners. There is that one. And second one to another corner. In there. Okay, and first we insert all of those bolts and nuts, and then we start to tighten those. And we continue. Okay, and now I have installed all of those bolts in there, 8 bolts, and then start this tightening. And this is like normal cylinder head tightening, that we start in this central area, and we tighten first in that one, and then second in here in back, and then in here in down, and then this corner in there, and then this corner in here, and this one in here, and that one in there. And now I start to use this moment, and this moment in here is again this 10, not very much. And I start in this bolt, and I thicken it like half rotation, and then I go in here down, and I check all time this moment tools, this amount, that there is maximum this 10, and then I go in here and I thicken that half rotation, and then I go in back in here, and then in here down this one, and then I go in here. And then in here. And then in here. Okay, and now I have taken all of these and this turn again. I start in here. Now I have this one in there, and I check all time this moment, that this moment must be this then, like when we look in here. This is only 10, not 20. Okay, and then back in here, and I tick them this so long that I can't anymore keep more this force, because this 10 is this maximum. Okay, this one there, okay. This was by the way already too thick, and I saw that how much there is now. This measurement shows that there is just 10, and I can't move this anymore, because this measurement goes too high, and this is just now in moment. Then, okay, and I double check all of these that they are in this moment. Okay, then this one, this is also. And then that one, it's also. In that I can little bit move more. Also in this. Then I check also the central bolts. Now they are a little bit loosened. I can thicken this more. Okay. And then next step is that we need to insert back in this electric cable what was in here. And then these cables, that cable first, and we press this in here, and then the second cable in just in here, it goes in here. Okay, now this. Now these pipes are okay, and then only we check that this is thickened. Okay, and then this. We have these bolts, and they goes in here. There is this first one, and then this second one in there. And this moment is same in here. This 10 lbf, and I use this friends, okay, and then this one, okay, good, and then I distance these bolts. And why I use this moment tool is also that I don't destroy those aluminium bolts, those screws in there, those threads. Okay, and now they are thickened. And next part is that we insert those ignition coils back, and we continue. Okay, and then next step is to insert these ignition coils back. This was first one. Then second. And third. And fourth. Okay, and then carefully those wires back, that we hear this click, 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 and then next step is to insert these bolts in back. Bolts back. And then I need to thicken these bolts. And I use that friends again. That one also. This was not in place. Okay, and here was difficulties. I'll take this wire away, and then I adjust this again. There was trick that I need to lift this back area wire. Interesting. There is okay, and then third one. And then this fourth one. And then when this is ready, we can start this engine and check that do we have any leaks, oil leaks in there. But if you use new gasket in the cylinder cover head, then I think that you don't have any leaks, but it's good to check. And again, 10 lbf feet is this moment. Okay, and then I check that all wires are back, and this click is now nice. And then I need to, of course, remember to hook up this battery back in there, and I connect this battery back. Okay, and then I start the engine, and we check that do we have any leaks. Okay, and then I go to start this engine, and we check that do we have any leaks in here. Okay, and I start the engine, and we check that how our glue sealant has been worked. Is there any leaks in there? And then I stop the engine. Okay, and this first look was that there was no any leak, and I am very happy if this is really true. Of course, I trust those Loctite products, because Loctite, those sealing glues, come from UK, England, and English are very good to do those chemical products. And then we check also this upper, this area, exhaust pipe area, is there any leaks, and we continue. Okay, and then we check that do we have here any leaks, and I can't see any leaks yet. And then it's important that when we have this glue in there, that we need to warm up this car. I think that at least 30 minutes that this glue start to work. And I let this motor to run 30 minutes, and then we check the result again. And we continue. Thank you.